whether declaring something a threat to peace and security has the desired effects, whether the call for global coordination has the desired effects, maybe a debatable question. I think there's a lot of evidence that it does have an effect in building morale around the world, and morale is linked to behavior change. If people have hope and they believe that resources are going to be forthcoming, they're more inclined to follow the strictures. If they become fatalistic, they're not. So I think those kinds of words and the show of unity really does matter. But even if you want to debate that point, the show of disunity is devastating. It's devastating for developing countries that already feel completely cut off from the rest of the world because flights have been ended, because factories have ceased production, because there's no way to get your goods to market because the connectivity has shut down, where there is no $2 trillion stimulus available to subsidize those people who've been laid off already in what will prove to be the early days of the crisis. I mean, we're really only in the early days as it relates to the globe. So my message will be, we have compounded a disaster and a humanitarian catastrophe so far. Let's right the ship. Let's show that the United Nations and we, each of our national governments, were built for moments like this. And let's recognize that as long as there is the COVID virus raging in one part of the world, none of us is safe. And as a result, let's put out the call now for the kind of global coordination and coalition that we need to eradicate the virus, not only in our own neighborhoods, which is, of course, our priority, but wherever it rages around the world.